Hello everyone, my name is Rui, and in this video, we're going to take a first look at the DataMiner Planned Maintenance app and all it can do for your business. Let's get into it. In a world where network infrastructure grows in complexity and relies even more on virtualization, it is difficult to predict the impact of taking a device out of production to perform maintenance jobs during a given time window. This is especially inconvenient when using conventional tools or documentation tools that are not necessarily designed to plan and handle network maintenance processes, which can lead to mistakes and interfere with your operations. DataMiner Planned Maintenance is an out-of-the-box application that enables you to schedule, manage, and perform maintenance jobs on your network confidently and safely. Performing maintenance impacts every operational domain: fault and configuration management, SLA and accounting, performance management, and of course, security. DataMiner takes care of all those things. But performing maintenance can cause alarm storms or trigger a surge of notifications. The Planned Maintenance app can be configured to mask alarms originating from the affected operations and products that are connected upstream, downstream. You can swap alarm templates, suspend KPIs and SLAs, you name it. However, this is more than just a maintenance planning tool. Because it is integrated with the whole DataMiner ecosystem, you leverage a suite of capabilities which work together to monitor and orchestrate your infrastructure, fitting to the workflows you need. For instance, switching your live event to a redundant resource when a planned maintenance is due. Moreover, integration with process automation means complete workflows can be attached to maintenance cycles like software updates, health checks, and golden configurations that will be automatically applied after maintenance jobs. In this demo, we're going to give you a look at how you can plan a maintenance job using the DataMiner Planned Maintenance app. First, we'll head out to Planned Maintenance app on the DataMiner services. Click New to schedule a new maintenance job. We'll start by giving it a name, like Fiberlink Maintenance. We can set the time window to determine when the maintenance process is going to start and when it's going to end. So we'll schedule it for 14:55 and end at 14:57. In the description field, we write up information that constitutes the maintenance process. For example, this maintenance will be done on the Fiberlink route between the Agder County and the Farsund regional head end. It is possible to assign a priority to a maintenance job, but more on this later. Specialized instructions intended for technicians can be filled in the summary. Example, clean the connectors, replace a segment, etc. A maintenance job can be assigned to one or more people to be notified of the scheduling and get access to details. In this case, we'll assign it to myself. The options are intended to address foreseeable behavior that is expected during the maintenance period. Technically, messing around with a product can very well trigger some alarms, so we're going to mask the alarms on the resource itself. Just so you know, you can also mask alarms on products downstream and upstream here too. Finally, we select the resources upon which the maintenance is going to be done. Today, as mentioned before, we're going to do maintenance on the Fiberlink 8300-5381. At the end, click Save. Now that the maintenance is planned, we expect it to take place at the hour we set. Let us head over to Cube to check the current state of our planned maintenance. We can do so by navigating to the DataMiner PLM app and selecting PLM instances on the top left corner. In this list view, we can find our own PLM instance and the properties we set. However, we can observe that the maintenance is not entirely ready to take place because it first requires approval. When approval is given, the PLM job status changes to approved, and the maintenance window will now take place at the specified time. While we wait, it's probably good to mention that you can now also verify that the Fiberlink in question is currently booked for that maintenance activity in the resources occupancy, which provides an alternative scheduled-oriented view from the SRM perspective. Now let's jump ahead to the maintenance start time. When the maintenance is taking place, the status will switch to running. During the maintenance window, we can take a look at the EPM topology where the fiber link resides and see how the process is affecting operations. The fiber link is located between the Ahder County and the Farsund regional headend. The Farsund regional headend is purple. That's because we chose to mask the alarms of that resource for the duration of the maintenance process. Again, it's possible to opt to mask alarms on resources downstream or upstream from this one. Now let's jump forward to the end of the maintenance cycle. Finally, when the maintenance concludes after the specified stop time, the PLM instance status will change to completed. If we head back to check on the EPM topology, we will find that the resources affected during the maintenance window are displayed as blue, as they are now fully monitored again. When a maintenance job gets disapproved or does not obtain approval during the designated time window, it will be rejected and not take place, as we can see from the previously rejected jobs. Additionally, tickets can be automatically pushed to your OSS ticketing platform whenever a problem arises that needs human intervention. Furthermore, it supports integration with collaboration tools. The communication between the team members can be optimized, for example, by creating a Teams channel with the operators and technicians involved in a specific job. That's all we got to show you about DataMiner Planned Maintenance for now. For more information, please visit our Dojo community on community.dataminer.services. Do register and stay up to date on all that good stuff. My name is Rui, and I will see you on the next one.